Rock and Roll Geek Show 913.
Still rocking after all these years.
This is the story of my rock and roll butler.
This is it, the show that started it all. Often imitated, but never equal. From San Francisco, USA. Online since 2004. Right. It's the one and only Rock and Roll Geek Show. With the original rock and roll geek, Michael Butler.
Welcome to the Rock and Roll Geek Show. My name is Michael Butler. Thanks a lot for joining me. I really appreciate it. Today is Saturday, May 4th, 2019. May the 4th be with you, as they say in baseball on this special day. It's 6:16 p.m. I don't know what the hell I'm talking about. I went fishing today. There was a handline fishing tournament in Alameda. And I had a bad back before I went, and when I got back from fishing, my back is like 20 times worse. So I'm suffering through this episode because that's how important you are to me, friends. I go through the pain of the doing a rock and roll geek show when I'm in excruciating back pain. But I'm doing it. I'm taking one for the team. All right. Thank you for joining me, friends. Tonight, I'm going to do a track-by-track of the brand-new Wild Hearts album, which is called Renaissance Men. Is that what that's what it's called, right? Renaissance Men. Came out on Friday, and I have a lot of thoughts about it. A lot of people are really, really high on this album, so we are going to listen to it together and judge for ourselves how great we think it is, all right? Before we do that, I would like to start off with a song by the Dickies. The Dickies have a brand new 7-inch out. I don't know if you know who the Dickies are, but they were a huge influence on my old band, Stevie Stiletto, back in the 80s. We really loved them a lot. They had, they were kind of probably one of the originators of the pop punk. And they have a new 7-inch. It's called I Dig Go-Go Girls, which is a Cheap Trick cover, but it never came out on a Cheap Trick album until they reissued the first album with bonus tracks on it. I think this is like an outtake from the first album from Cheap Trick. Well, the Dickies covered it on this 7-inch. The 7-inch is out on Slope Records, May 24th, and the singer is, they have a special guest singer. It is Monkey from a band called The Addicts, and The Addicts are quite influential as well, as you know, I'm sure. And I don't know what the hell I'm talking about, so I'm just going to play a brand new song from the Dickies, cover of Cheap Trick, I Dig Go-Go Girls, with special guest Monkey from the Addicts.
No one can speak to me. I love a
there you go, the Dickies. Covering Cheap Trick's I Dig Go-Go Girls. It's pretty good. It's that's the original. It's pretty true to the original, and the original is you can find it on YouTube, and or if you have the reissue of the first album, it's kind of quirky just like that. But yeah, there you go. Brand new Dickies with Mucky from the Attics guest vocals. The B side is called The Dreaded Pigasaurus. Dickies were always great live. I've seen them a few times live, and they were always a lot of fun live. They've been around since like 1977. All right, before we get into the track-by-track of the new Wild Hearts album, Renaissance Men, I would like to thank people who donate to the show. We find some music to play in the background. Rick Springfield's got a brand new album out called Orchestrating My Life, which is kind of a greatest hits re-recorded with a orchestra as the backing track. Let me find something. Oh, I'll do. I've done everything for you. Thank you for donating to the show, friends. As you know, this show is a value for value. You donate to the show what you think it's worth. And without your donations, friends, this show would die horrible, putrid, stench-filled death. I have not heard this album yet. Listen to a little bit of it. Take, I can't take it, you see. But I'm giving up on love this time. Me and my friends will do just fine. I've done everything for you. Oh, that sounds good. I don't care about the orchestra, but I love Rick Springfield, so. So there are several ways you can donate to the show. One, you can just walk up to me and hand me cash like Brian Vaughn did, $40 cash, walked up to me on the Butlers on the stage when the Butlers were playing and just handed me $40. You can also go to patreon.com/rnrgeek. And the following people did that. Michael Brown, one of my oldest friends, donates $25 every episode. Joseph Coyne, brand new donor, I think. $10. Joe Pawlak, my bodyguard, $6.66. Derek Lewis, $5 every episode. Dan Gerowan, thank you for the $5. Brian Springer for the $5. Betty Wood, $5. Grant Fauqua, $5. Jamie Jefford, $5. Marshall York, $5. Tim Shaw, $5. Robert Harvey, $5. Brad Schick, $5. Daniel Segan, $5. Michael Street, who's coming into town next week. We're going to go see Todd Rundgren. He donates $5 every episode. Thank you, Ken Kennedy, for the $5. Probably have to burp up this fine Tecate. Went down the wrong pipe. Thank you to Chiaki Hinohara, my good friend Chiaki Hinohara of the Metal Moment podcast and Japanese Metalhead show. Well, I don't get to see that often anymore because he's got a new job and he's working his ass off. Thank you, my podcast mentor and co-host of Mad at Dad, Dave Slusher, for the $5. Thank you to John Boveri for the $5. Thank you to Derek Coward from Comic Book Noise for the $2.50 every episode. Thank you, Chad Burns, for the $2.50 every episode. Thank you to Paul Rube for the $2.25. Thank you to Adrian Boschon, Bosch Rock on the forums and the Facebook page, which I did not create, but I do approve people. You just have to answer two questions so that I know you are not a government spy for North Korea. Thank you, Adrian Boschon, for the $2 every episode. Thank you, Patrick Shanahan, for the $2. Thank you, Kirk Crawford, for the $2. I'm finding some Human Touch. That's probably my favorite Rick Springfield. Let's hear how that sounds. Okay. Thank you to Mike Dixon for the $2. Thank you to Paul Underwood, maker of the fine Underwood barbecue sauce, for the $2. Thank you to Stephen McIntyre for the $2. Thank you to Bruce McMillan for the $2. Thank you to Matthew Hunt for the $2. Thank you to Eric Stowell for the $2. Thank you to @MetalDan, Amelia Bowen, Bonstone, John Richardson, Arnie Stash, Three Legs, Four Wheels, and Corey Kohler for the $1. I love Rick Springfield, man. Alright, let me hear the chorus and I'll thank the rest of the people.
Come on, girl. We all need the human touch. We all need the human touch. I need it.
What a catchy chorus.
We all need.
Alright, thank you to Rodney Cross. Oh, you can go to you can donate to PayPal. You can go to PayPal. All these links are at rockandrollgeek.com. Just click the donate button, the donate link. Rodney Cross donated $100 for the Tacoma payments. I got a huge car payment now that I smashed my Tacoma up, so he donated $100. Thank you to Eric Lamke, donated $100. Richard Fusey donated $40 to the Tacoma donation. Thank you to Sensory Abuse for the $40 donation. Another new donor, Donald Patterson from Jacksonville, Florida, donated $20. That sounds good. Let me see what else they have here. Don't talk to the strangers. How about a Fear of the Heart? Fear of the Heart. Here we go. All right. You want to hear Jesse's Girl, right? Here, let's hear how Jesse's Girl sounds with the orchestra. Where am I here? Thank you to Douglas Free for the $20. Thank you to Elodie Johns, my first girlfriend, for the $20. Thank you to Jerry. Take two. Thank you to Jeff and Sherry Thielalicki. Not Jeff and... It could be Chef and Jerry Thielalicki, but it's Jeff and Sherry Thielalicki for the $10. Thank you to Dave Franco for the $10. Thank you to friend of the show and friend of mine, Todd Cunningham, for the $10. Thank you to Dave Jackson and the School of Podcasting for the $10. Thanks to friend of the show and friend of mine, Ralph Miller, for the $10. Thanks to BJ Lisco for the $10. Thanks to Dick Shuijit. He's from the Netherlands. Dick Shuijit for the $5. Dick, however you pronounce your last name, Shuijit for the $5. Thank you to Benjamin Mueller for the $5. Thank you to Andrew Howe for the $5. Thanks to Dale Roller for the $5. Thanks to Christopher Del Grande for the $5. Thanks to Richard Strom for the $5. Thank you to Kelly Mitchell for the $5. Thank you to Sigmund Heidacher for the $5. Thank you to Jer O'Carroll for the $5. Thank you to Peter Spark for the $5. Thank you to Brett Garski for the $5. Thank you to John Offenlock for the $5. Thank you to John Tennis for the $5. Greg Long for $5. Derek Bow for the $5. Thank you to Eric Lentz for the $5. Thank you to Kelly Mitchell for another fiver. Thank you to Michael Williams for the $5. Thank you to Richard Fusey for another $5. Thanks to William Moffitt for the $2. Thank you to Deborah Dreyfus, if that's your real name, for the $2. Thank you to Richard Fusey for another $2. Thank you to Jason Wendleton for the $2. Lassie Satvedhagen for the $2. Thank you to John Skiller for the $2. And finally, Bradford Page for the $2. Thank you to everybody who donates to the Rock and Roll Geek Show. Because without your donations, this show would die a horrible, putrid, stench-filled, back-breaking death. I really appreciate it, friends, truly. I take a sip of this fine Tecate to everybody who donated. Ah! All right, you ready to do the track by track of the new Wild Hearts Renaissance Men? By popular demand, it was demanded by Alex Oliver, who also sent me a show review that I'll play later. And other people demanded it as well. It was sent to me by several people, but I had already pre-ordered it. I didn't pre-order the CD or the vinyl because it's quite expensive as an import, but I ordered the MP3s. And the MP3s on Amazon did not come with liner notes, but I did ask somebody to send me the liner notes, and somebody did. I don't remember who did it, but whoever sent them, thank you so much, friend. I really appreciate it. There are 10 tracks on the album, Renaissance Men. It's recorded, like I said, it came out on Friday. It was recorded at a place called Treehouse Studio. Jim Pender engineered it. Also engineered, initial engineering by Dan Jaffery. Mixed by Jim Pender and Carl Baun, and mastered by Dave Draper. All right. This is the first album that they've done since about 10 years. And the first one with Danny McCormick back in the band since, what was the last album he was on? PHUQ? It's been a long time. And since then, Danny was in a great band called the Yo-Yos, and he was in a band called the Main Grains. Danny, great bass player and a super talented dude. He now only has one leg, so he's playing seated. He had a lot of, I don't know why he lost his leg, but I'm guessing that he probably had contacted diabetes or something like that. But he's been through a lot, but he's a great bass player, and I've never met him. Actually, I did meet him because American Heartbreak played a gig with the Choir Boys and the Yo-Yos in L.A. a long, long time ago. And I met him then, and we showered him with praise, telling him how much we loved him in the Wild Hearts. Anyway, so this is the first album with Danny back in the band, and he's got the rest of the people in the band, obviously, as you know, if you're a Wild Hearts fan, Rich Battersby and C.J. Wildheart on guitar, and Ginger, of course. They're on the front album cover, it's just the four of the guys wearing leather jackets, looking real serious, and they kind of look like they're aging a little bit. I think that was the idea with the album cover. There are 10 tracks on it. Let me find something to write with here. Write on. Da-da-da-da-da. An envelope here. All right. Now my back is killing me. All right. And I will use the Wild Hearts Zealotin Wonderland sent to me by, I believe, by Adrian Bosch. Yeah, Adrian sent me this. Let me see. Wild Hearts. We write it down. So there's 10 tracks. And as you know, if I like the song, I give it a plus one. This is the Rock and Roll Geek scoring system. If I like the song, I give it a plus one. If it's okay, I give it a half. And if I don't like it, I get a zero. I give it a zero. And I tally them all up. So if I gave every song a half, this album would be a 5 out of 10. Okay, Wild Hearts. Wild Hearts. All right, first song is called Dislocated, which I have played on the Rock and Roll Geek Show already once. Massively heavy. One thing I'll say right off the bat, this album, the mix on this album, little distorted, and I think that was what they wanted. I think because Ginger had told me before, if I can drop names, that his favorite Wild Hearts album was Endless Nameless. And Endless Nameless, the recording is so distorted, you can almost not even hear it. This is not quite like that, but it's kind of distorted. Ginger sounding extremely pissed off. Super heavy. Barn burner, as Casey Crenshaw says. All right, then it changes tempo and goes into a hook. the songs in this album, except for one, was written by Ginger himself. To another part. Epic album opener. I'm exhausted just listening to it. It's a great song, obviously, but I'm going to give it a half. It's probably my least favorite song on the album, but man, is it brutal. It just pounds you over the head like a fucking sledgehammer, man. All right, next song is called Let It Go, or excuse me, Let 'Em Go, featuring guest vocals by Frank Turner. Is that right, Frank Turner vocals? Yes. Frank Turner, yes. Frank Turner appears on track 2, courtesy of Polydor Records. Used to be on Epitaph Records, I think, or Fat Records. All right, Let 'Em Go!
Let 'Em Go! Let 'Em
Go! All right, right off the hat, with right off the bat with a hook. Anthemic chorus, verse, chaos and noisy, but kind of classic Wild Hearts. A little super shit 666 verse, kind of. Super catchy chorus. I love the chorus. Great bridge. Love this part. And you can hear Frank Turner's vocals.
Time to take back, time to take it back, time to let go.
I'm not a huge fan of modulation, but this one, it modulates several different, it's super modulation, so I kind of like it. Nice breakdown.
Let the shit-filled rivers flow while your belly burns in anger. No one ever needs to know. Let them go.
That's a big plus one. What a catchy tune, man. Reminds me a little bit of I Want to Go Where the People Go. Oh, yeah, that was great. Man, you almost have to listen to the songs when I'm doing the track by track of this one, I almost have to play the songs in their entirety because there's just so many damn parts to the song. You need to hear them all. All right, next song is called The Renaissance Men. Title track of our new album, The Renaissance Men. You know what that reminds me of? A little bit of Michael Jackson, Black or White. Is that the song? Black or... Doesn't matter if you're black or white. Love the melodic guitar part over it. I love it. Another big plus one. Renaissance Man. I'll give it a plus one. Next song, Fine Art of Deception. If I'm pissing up, I'm in. Down your hall. Let me back it up. When it starts off like that, I'm already into the song. If I'm pissing up and down your hall, and if I'm casting shadows on your wall. Great lyrics. By the way, the lyrics on this album, I've listened to this album probably about 10 times now since I got it on Friday. Lyrics on this album are some of the best lyrics you will hear on a record this year. Don't let my proximity mean what it may imply. I'm just working on a way to say goodbye. If I step in circles round the floor. You hear that? There, you could be driving, go da-da-da-da-da-da-da, but he throws in a da-da-da-dark. Well, I'll back it up a little bit, too. That's the kind of shit that I love. In circles round the floor. that. You can see at a show when if the Wild Hearts play this tune live, the whole entire audience is going to be yelling bullshit. Big plus one. Next song, Diagnosis. Possibly, well, I'll let you hear. This is 5 minutes and 51 seconds of epic awesomeness. Diagnosis. Starts off a little bit like Black Shuck from The Darkness. That's badass. I love it. And it gets better. Building. One minute and 21 seconds of slow build, then goes into an MC5 lift. And then into a major hook verse. All the while, it's still driving. Man, this song is amazing.
Read 'em and wake your
comes the chorus. Oh, man. Such an angry song, but so fucking catchy. Oh, man. Badass. It has everything. It has everything you want in a Wild Heart song. It has a little bit of 29 Times the Pain anthem music wise. Super catchy chorus, anger, heaviness. Listen to this. Listen to the lyrics and the anger in Ginger's voice. It's just so fucking amazing. Breakdown. If you could justify the letters on the name on the plaque upon the wall. Great lyrics. And if you look a bit harder, great lyrics. I'm going to back it up. Let you listen to, just pay attention to the lyrics. Wild Hearts fans, if they play this live, they're going to go ape shit. They're the kind of, you know, a lot of bands, they have a new, they'll put out a new record and the band will, and fans will go to the bathroom. Not when they play new, not when the Wild Hearts fans, when the Wild Hearts play new songs, the Wild Hearts fans are so loyal. They're up, they're into every one of them. They are going to be so into this album. Breakdown. This song is fucking sick, man. Roller coaster going back up the tracks. Oh, that song knocked my fucking dick in the dirt, man. If I could give that one a plus two, I would, but I can only give it a plus one for the Rock and Roll Geek scoring system. possibly my favorite Wild Heart song I've ever heard. That song was just flat out amazing. Amazing. All right, next song, My Kinda Movie. My Kind of Movie. AC/DC lick. A little bit like Sucker Punch from Earth Versus, which, as you know, is one of the greatest albums ever made. Rich Batters be killing it. And the classic Wild Heart. That AC/DC lick is badass too. Here comes the chorus. It almost inflicts pain on you listening to it. It's just bludgeoning you upside the head. Listen to, all right, let's back it up again. So the main lick, da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da, listen to how it goes into the solo. Climb up. Wow. Listen to that. Holy shit, and a catchy as hell chorus. It's like the heaviest thing that Metallica ever did, mixed with Cheap Trick. Fuck. Listen to the end of that again. Woo! That was just crushing. Absolutely crushing and catchy. I'd give it a big plus one. Holy shit, that is fucking rocking. So far, we got every song's a plus one except for the first one. Next song, the only one not written by Ginger. This one's written by CJ Wildheart. Little Flower. Right into the chorus. Don't bore us, get to the chorus. Run together. singing along immediately. Again, the only thing that I can say that I'm that so far that I'm not pleased with is the mix. A lot of people love the Endless Nameless mix. I'm not a big fan of it, but that's the only. Other than that, these songs are just killing me. That is that lick is a little bit TV Tan from Earth Verse. TV Tan or Greetings from Shitsville. Super, super catchy chorus. I would like to hear CJ's demo of this. I bet it's way different. All right, my fucking ears are bleeding, man, and in a good way. I'm exhausted listening to it. Plus one. Number eight, Emergency, and in parentheses, Fentanyl Babylon. Holy shit. B section, super hook. Of course, catchy. Then back into pounding you over the head. I would almost give this a half, but the pre-chorus and the chorus kind of bring it back up to a one. Wow. My fucking ears are bleeding. And Rich Battersby, man, that guy's an underrated drummer. I had the pleasure of playing one of Ginger's birthday parties in London. Rock and Roll Geek Friends took up a collection and flew me out. And I got to play with Rich. I got to play some of the songs with Rich Battersby when on drums. Man, it's even better when you're standing next to him and as a bass player. That's the kind of drummer you want as a bass player. That one I want to give it a plus one. I think I'm going to give it a half just so I can keep my rock cred, you know, so I don't, it doesn't look like I'm kissing Ginger's ass. Number nine, My Side of the Bed. What was that? Was that his wife bitching at him? Noise. Total noise, but a little bit like if life is like a love bank, I want an overdraft. Super hook. I was a little fish. The girls are always tough as the lights. Oh yeah, that's catchy as hell. The way that I saw the fear of women that the industry had. The men became our feet. They were afraid to compete. The mental power is dead. It was a culture of fear. So I made a place here on my side of the bed. I love the that too. Then changes into a completely different part. More catchy. It changes into a bridge that's more catchy than the chorus and the verse. Oh, that's awesome. Then it goes into a part that's even more catchy than everything before it. Oh, God, that's badass. I'm back it up here. I'm sorry, friends. If I'm creaming over this, I apologize. Listen to that. Because the standards are behind a basic grip on morality. The evolution of the self is all the same. Friends, we are living in the presence of one of the greatest songwriters of our time. Eddie Trunk talks about Rival Sons. The new Rival Sons is the best. I try listening to that new Rival Sons. He says the songs are so catchy. That right. Please. This is a fucking masterpiece. That you'll ever need. Don't take the easy thoroughfare. You know that it's full of cunts down there. I never met a racist growing up with me mates. Cause the blacks were... Tempo change and key change. I do see the later when I moved away. A xenophobia in the readers of the Daily Mail. Without the things that I've seen, they never see what I mean or hear a word that I said. They're all gutless and green, yeah, cause they never been here on my side of the bed. Aww. Super melodic solo. Holy shit, there's so much going on in this song. I got to catch my breath. That was an amazing song. They don't write them. You hear all the parts in that song? And every fucking part was more catchy than the one before it. Holy shit, that was a badass tune. All right, final song. Piloerection. I have no idea what that means. Heaviness into hook. For me, I'm aware I need somewhere to share my energy. I know that I don't know you. I'll never want to own you. But I'm someone to turn to. When the world looks terrifying, a teddy bear. From hook to heaviness and back. Life is reassembling. I can feel you trembling. It's a natural thing. Don't be scared of anything. I know life has hurt you. Been unkind and untrue. But over time I learned you. Take the bad times and the joy. All right, let me tally it up, shall we? We got half. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And two halves. 9 out of 10. Do you agree with me, friends? Send me an email, rockandrollgeek@gmail.com, with the subject line, Butler. You're absolutely right. This album smashed my head against the wall. Put that in the subject line, rockandrollgeek@gmail.com. If you disagree with me and think this album's a piece of crap, in the subject line, Butler, could you suck Ginger off anymore with your ass kissing? This record blows! Put that in the subject line, rockandrollgeek@gmail.com. Heavier than anything that I've heard in a long time, and catchier. How many bands can say that in the same description of the same album? All right, there you go. Whew. All right, let's cleanse our eardrums with a little bit of, with an audio comment. By the way, once again, the record's called Renaissance Men from Wild Hearts. I'll put a link where you can purchase it on rockandrollgeek.com. So far, obviously, my pick for the album of the year so far. Way better than, what's that band called? Rival Sons. There you go. All right. Audio comment.
Michael Butler, how the devil are you, sir?
Hello.
It's Alex Botham Mall here, phoning in with the show review. Oh, first of all, how are you?
I'm super.
Super great. Couldn't be better. Stay frosty, etc. Yep, yeah. Me too, mate. Show of you.
Alex Oliver, maker of the Rock and Roll Geek clothing line and bathroomwall.co.uk. Alex Oliver, a friend of mine. One of the people who got me to Europe, to England, to play with Ginger. He was pretty much instrumental in getting me over there.
Fine. Now, usually I appreciate it. I phone up with, that was dreadful, or that was good, or meh, and leave it at that, because... All due respect to the guys that like to leave long show reviews, but long show reviews, yeah, if you must.
He finds
at least
them
there's a skip button, I suppose. Anyway.
He finds them boring.
Iggy Pop. Now, I've seen Iggy, like sure a lot of you have, and Iggy's always great. But usually, you see Iggy Pop these days, he tends to play festivals and stuff, and I've retired from festivals, so I don't see him at festivals. Or you see him at theatres. Like, the last time I saw him was when he reformed the Stooges a few years ago and they played War Power, and they played, before that, it was when they played Funhouse and stuff. And it was great, but it was in small, sweaty venues, you know, where you stick to the floor, the walls are sweating, you know, proper grimy places that you'd expect to, you know, hear that stuff played. This was at the Sydney Opera House. Yeah, the Sydney Opera House. You know that... The
in Australia.
Big building in Sydney, the white thing looks like a pile of washing up. Yeah, it's an opera house.
Well, I believe,
you go
no,
and
that's
see.
Right. Alex lives in Australia now, doesn't he?
Opera there. Or
by you the way,
see...
with that comment, Alex, you know you know people are going to be pressing the skip button on this, don't you?
Ballet. Or if you see modern music, you might go and see Bob Dylan there. You don't see fucking Iggy Pop there. Well, I did. It was just the most amazing thing I've ever seen. Well, not saying it's the greatest concert I've ever been to by a long shot, but it was a 72-year-old man up there flinging himself around like I doubt I could do when I was 16. I know you jump about a bit, Michael, but this is Iggy Pop. He's just phenomenal. Quite how he does it, and the intensity of the show, and his voice, I can't believe how well that has held up. You know, you compare it to much younger singers than him, that, you know, other punks. If anyone's seen John Lydon recently, I know someone phoned in with a thinking Pill were a bit shit live, and yeah, I could have told you that. You know, his voice isn't good, not that he was ever good, but he just sounds shit now. You look at someone like Vince Neil, it just bloody awful. Iggy Pop's his really strong baritone voice. The band are shit hot, as you'd expect. You know, he picks up,
who's
they may
the
just
band?
Be playing three chord punk, but they are really on it. A horn section's pretty damn good too.
Who's in Iggy Pop's band now, Alex?
As for the set list, he starts off with you know, Passengers.
Okay.
Lust for Life.
I am a passenger. La 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 la. Is that the same song? I got a lust for life.
Some of the solo stuff you'd expect. Actually, no, he started with I Want to Be Your Dog.
Oh. Now he's open with I Want to Be Your Dog?
And then he went into those. And he played through all the sort of main Stooges stuff and the Stooges things you'd expect. You know, he went through some I'm Bored, you know, and then
he played I'm Bored. That's a good one. I didn't know I'd never seen him play I'm Bored live. That's a good one. I'm the chairman of the board. What's that on? Is that on Soldier?
Well, I mean,
or the Idiot?
You know, it was just the intensity of it. And during No Fun, he decides to invite
No Fun, my friend. No Fun.
Age. Not just like a special guest here and there. He invites half the fucking audience up there. There's like 100 people on stage. And if anyone's seen Iggy before, you know that he often does this. And you know he's got a tour manager that just genuinely punches people in the head if they overstep the mark. So he's old bloke's up there flinging punches at random people. And they're just smiling back at him because they're on stage with the king. And yeah, because Iggy Pop is the king. You know, we hear people banging on about, oh, I'm going to go and see the king's grave in Graceland. It's like, the king ain't even dead, you know, and why would Iggy Pop be buried in Memphis anyway?
He is
anyway?
The king of punk rock, that's for sure.
Yeah, you know, Iggy's just the most intense thing you've ever seen. You know, you listen to that Henry Rollins piece about how great he is, and about how... just alive, he will take anyone apart, and he does. And he keeps going. He climbs up the PA stack. He swings on curtain drapes, you know, from the backstage.
Iggy Pop is the real deal.
He falls into the stage.
There's nothing fake about Iggy Pop.
The stage, rather, a number of times. You know, and the crowd just hand him straight back. And they don't quite know what to do because they see this elderly man fall off the stage. And your usual reaction to an old man falling off the stage is to, you know, make sure he hasn't popped a hip or something. And they start like that, and then they realise this...
Speaking of popping hips, I think I popped my back, man. Oh. Oh. And Iggy Pop's running all over the stage. Oh. My back's killing me.
He's invincible, and they just start bouncing around with him. So he plows through all the stuff you'd expect him to. Then he finished with Wed Right Hand, the cover of Nick Cave and a Bad Seed song. I know it's not your sort of thing at all, but in Iggy's hands, I think it's a lot better than Nick Cave's version. Plus, Nick Cave being Australian, it's a thing here. It's every time a band comes to Australia, they feel they have to play an Australian song of some sort. Usually, it's an AC/DC song. Sometimes, you know, they'll branch out into the easy beats or go, you know, for cultures or something. But usually it's that. So to hear a Nick Cave song was quite unusual, and the crowd really appreciated it. And then we all went home. Oh, but not before I saw two fantastic people wearing my T-shirts, which was really nice.
There was a bloke
in an Iguanas T-shirt, which was about the third design ago of that. So the fact that was still in one piece was quite good. And the other one was a bloke wearing exactly the same T-shirt that I was wearing, which is kind of quite funny, really. But you know, you can always go to bathroommall.com and get them for yourself. Use code I Love Michael Butler.
Free shipping.
Anyway, that's enough of my yabbering or whatever your phrase thing is. I'll phone back with another of you soon because I'm off to see, what am I going to see next? I'm going to see Danko Jones soon. And I'm going to see, I think I'm going to see Rose Tattoo and the Hard-Ons. I want to see the Hard-Ons. I want to see Rose Tattoo. The problem is it's an election here at the moment. And Angry Anderson and politics, it's not good. It turns out that Angry Anderson, as great a frontman as he is rather a nasty little cunt.
Do you think he's going to be spouting off politics on stage?
Not sure I want to see him when there's politics kicking around. So we'll have to see. I might go.
Don't let your hero's politics interfere with the love of their music. I have seen Rose Tattoo. I've saw video footage of Rose Tattoo on that Monsters of Rock cruise, and they were the best band on that cruise. They blew everybody away.
Ignore it, but he does tend to attract not the nicest crowd, really. Especially here in Brisbane, where, you know, it's a bit rednecky. So anyway, there we go. That's me done. Talk to you soon. Cheers, mate. Bye.
All right. You too can leave me an audio comment. You can call area code 706-621-ROCK. That's area code 706-621-7625. But I would prefer you do like Alex Oliver from bathroomwall.co.uk or bathroommall.com or ilovemichaelbutler.com. Use the promo code ilovemichaelbutler. Get free shipping anywhere in the world. I'd prefer you did it like Alex and just emailed it to rockandrollgeek@gmail.com. All right, do I have anything? I think I got, what else do I have on my list here? Let's see, I got an email. What do you make of, from Joe Coyne. What do you make of the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame? I go nuts every time it's even mentioned. Tonight I'm watching it as my blood is boiling. That's all right, the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame aired on HBO. Fortunately, or unfortunately, I don't know, I don't get HBO anymore because I have the Dish Network in my house, and Dish Network dropped HBO. So I have not seen the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame ceremony this year, and I don't really think I care to. He goes on asking me a bunch of more stuff, things, bands he thinks should be in rock. Well, I'll finish reading whatever. Radiohead, Roxy Music, what the fuck? Last year, same shit. The Cars, I mean, come on. The one group I'm really pushing for is Boston. Boston will never be in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, Joe Coyne. Never. Love that fucking group. That first Boston album, it's probably a perfect album. I mean, just the production, songs, great. It's a great album. They'll never be even considered for the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. Now, come on. Paul Rodgers is not even in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. Peter Frampton is not in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. Ted Nugent. I'm not going to go on a rant like Eddie Trunk does because it can be phony. That first album was the third album. That first Boston album was the third album I ever bought, and I still love it. I know they only have a couple of good albums. The first was amazing, but still compared to other groups, this is the only one group I've mentioning. I could go on. I'm interested in your take and would love to hear it on your podcast. Thanks, brother. Long live rock. You hear that? That's my dog, Cassie. Crying. We have a dog in heat. We had to separate him because he is not neutered, and he is ready to bang her. And he's crying because he's separated from her. His hormones are going crazy. Cassie, I should probably wrap this thing up soon. He also goes on to say, Joe Coyne says, how about a new group or song every new show? It don't have to be put out in 2019, but a way to open up people's minds to something they've never heard. All right. Well, I played a new song on the opening song, and I played a new album. So there you go, Joe Coyne. I did it. All right. That's about enough for tonight. I'm getting up at 4 a.m. and going fishing again. I don't know why I'm going fishing again because my sitting in that kayak today screwed my back up bad. And tomorrow, I'm getting up at 4 a.m. and going fishing in the ocean. Today, I went fishing in the bay. And the bay is a lot easier than the ocean. I'm doing a surf launch. It's going to be rocks everywhere. And I got a bad back. But I'm going fishing. If you don't hear from me again, friends, you might find me in the bottom of the ocean with a bad back. All right, I'm going to close out with one more thing here. New York Dolls guitarist Sylvain Sylvain is battling cancer. Now, this came out like a week ago. A fundraising campaign has been launched for Sylvain Mizrahi, also known as Sylvain Sylvain. Close the door on the dog. Recently diagnosed with cancer. They don't tell you what kind of cancer he has. He's been undergoing treatment that appears to be moving along successfully, but has a long way to go. So a GoFundMe has been set up for him to help him get back on his feet. In a message on the GoFundMe page, Sylvain wrote, I know there's been some curiosity, speculation, and yes, rumor about why I haven't been rampaging songs on Facebook or, more importantly, out on tour promoting my book, There's No Bones in Ice Cream, and playing in a town near you. First, the bad news. For a year now, I've been battling cancer. Then the good news. I have an upcoming surgery with a great doctor that may do the trick. There will, however, be a song. I apologize for the dog, friends. I think one time before there was a howling dog. That was when my other dog was in heat. He goes on to say, then the good news. I have an upcoming surgery with a great doctor, may do the trick. There will, however, be a somewhat long recovery period of at least a year. I have not been able to work since last year and have more surgery scheduled. I love life, and as hard as life has been to me in these past 2 years, I want to live, and I know with your love and support, I'll have the best chance that I could ever have. All right, so there's a GoFundMe page. I'll post a link to that from rockandrollgeek.com as well. He has an $80,000 goal. He's reached $48,185. So he's barely over halfway. It's been going on a week. He's halfway in a week. That's pretty good. So if you'd like to donate, I will post a link on rockandrollgeek.com to Sylvain Sylvain's GoFundMe page. I'm going to close out with a song by Sylvain Sylvain. Something from Syl Sylvain and the Teardrops, which came out in 19... I don't have a Wikipedia in front of me, but I think 1981. All right, before I play that, friends, I would like to thank you again for listening to the show. They can't all be winners. As a matter of fact, they probably, most of them won't be, but one thing for sure, they will be honest. And I appreciate you listening, friends. And thank you so much for donating. Because as you know, without your donations, this show would die horrible, putrid, stench-filled death. It's a value for value. What did you think this show was worth to you? Did you get any value from it? You got to hear pretty much the entire new Wild Hearts with a little bit of commentary in it. Almost every song completely all the way through. Did that give you any value? An hour and a half. It's almost the size, the length of a movie. Movie costs you. I don't have been to a movie lately. Probably 10 or 15, 20 bucks plus popcorn. You sit home and drink beer and listen to me do this bullshit. Whatever it's worth to you, friends, I ask that you please donate that. That will keep the lights on here. And if you do donate, I thank you so much, friends. That's enough of my yapping. I'm going to tell you how you can reach me. Rockandrollgeek.com is where you can find the show. You can send me an email, rockandrollgeek@gmail.com. You can find me on the Facebook, R&R Geek. You can find me on the Twitter, R&R Geek. The Patreons, patreon.com/R&R Geek. PayPal, just go to rockandrollgeek.com and click the link for the donate. And you can find me on the Instagram, Rock and Roll Geek, don't ask. That's enough ways to reach me. Thank you so much, friends. Here's Sylvain. I'm losing my voice already, just in the nick of time. Let me take a sip of this fine Tecate. Ah! I'm going to get this show posted and go to bed because I'm getting up at 4 a.m. Hopefully I'll wake up. The way I'm feeling right now, I may not, because my back is killing me. Here's Sylvain and the Teardrops from 1981. Crowded Love. Thanks for listening, friends. I'll talk to you soon.
Because I wake up every morning to the sound of the disco beat. All my neighbors say, darling, the kids are smoking cigarettes on the street. You see, I live in New York City. In a railroad flat, I got the bathroom and hallway, and I don't wanna get. Yes, I'm crowded, crowded love. Lucy was my first wife. She left me with 16 kids, and one day she decided to leave it. Left is what she did. See, she said her love was so much better the second time around. And ooh, darling, I'm left with. Cause since I'm crowded, crowded love. Ooh la 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 la. Ooh la 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 la. Since I'm crowded, crowded, crowded.
The Rock and Roll Geek Train Wreck.